Here is the deal. Imagine a situation if we get visited by aliens, but not in the way it's usually depicted in the movies when there is an inevitable fighting and conquering going on. What if instead they visit us as guests? As, you know, tourists. So the big question here is, where should we take them and what should we be showing them as a tourist attraction? Something that will really impress them, give them a once-in-a-lifetime experience, one they will be telling their friends about for years and decades to come. Do we actually have something like that? Well, let's figure this out. Of course, having aliens in any story automatically makes it more interesting, but the actual question here is much more serious and important than it seems at the first glance. Basically, what I'm really asking is if there is something in our solar system that is unique about it. Something that you wouldn't see in any of the places out there. Something that makes us stand out somehow. And from what we know, we live in a rather ordinary galaxy by a rather ordinary star. But can we find anything special about it that can serve as an alien tourist attraction? Well, the first thing that comes to mind is biological life. We don't seem to see any of that anywhere in other planetary systems or in galaxies. But the rules of the game is that we need to somehow impress aliens, meaning they are also a form of biological life, so despite the fact that it is kind of special, it doesn't really count in our made-up game, meaning we need to think further. Another thing that can be a definitive feature of our solar system is probably the rings of Saturn. After all, it's the most exciting thing you can see with your eyes in a telescope, and I bet there are really impressive up close. It's mind-blowing that a structure that can be seen from literally millions of kilometers away is in fact several meters thick. There are waves in the rings that look really cool, there are shepherd moons, it's so great. However, it might not be that impressive for our alien friends that have been to other planetary systems. You see, we now know about 5,000 confirmed exoplanets, which isn't much. And even among this small sample, we already know about a planet that has rings 200 times more massive than Saturn's. This means that if we'll try to use Saturn rings as a tourist attraction, we might look like rednecks showing a big local shed trying to impress someone who came from a place full of skyscrapers. Not cool. So, what else do we have? How about the Great Red Spot on Jupiter? Or maybe other really cool storms on other gas planets, like the Polar Hexagon on Saturn, Great Dark Spot on Neptune, or this beauty on the poles of Jupiter. Some might even think that it's a part of some kind of dark ritual. But despite this thing looking really cool on desktop wallpapers, they should be kind of common around the cosmos. There are a lot of gas planets out there, some much more extreme than what we have in our solar system, so it's safe to assume that we might have even more visible and significant weather patterns emerging. Meaning that all that, unfortunately, does not classify as a great tourist attraction despite looking sick for us. Well, maybe we should show them the heart of Pluto then. It's so cute and lovely and it's so cool that one of the dwarf planets has a feature like that. But heart symbols are only significant for us humans. For our alien guests, it might look like any other shape, and we will definitely have a hard time explaining why do we depict an organ that actually looks like this the way we do. Thus, we need other options. Well, what about Earth then? Maybe something here might be really unique and exciting. For example, here we have an atmosphere with clouds, oceans and seas of liquid water on the surface, and ice on the mountaintops and the poles. All three main states of matter at the same time on a single planet in a sustained cycle. But this feature technically isn't unique even within our solar system, because we have Titan, one of the moons of Saturn, that also has atmosphere, liquid lakes and seas, and ice at the same time. It's not water ice though, it's mainly methane and other hydrocarbons, but still. If a feature isn't unique here in our solar system, our alien guest would have probably seen something like that somewhere else and they won't be impressed. Well, how about thinking out of the box? So far we've been thinking about stuff that we have, but what about things we don't have? And this might be really interesting. There even was a scientific paper that tried to look at the solar system as if it was studied as one of the exoplanetary systems and looking into how it would compare. And generally, as I already said, we are pretty average in a lot of ways. But there are some interesting things though. Researchers say that our solar system stands out by lacking super-Earth, a type of rocky planets that is bigger than Earth but smaller than Neptune. Also, it's kind of weird that we don't have any planets within the orbit of Mercury that are closer to the Sun. So, in a way, our solar system is a bit unusual compared to the sample of systems that we now know about. But still, it would be very awkward to show our alien guest something that we lack and try to put it in as an attraction. So, does it mean that there isn't anything special about us? Do we have nothing to impress tourists who have been to other planets and stars? Are we really that boring and mundane? Well, on the one hand, that is exactly what the cosmological principle suggests, that our place in the universe is nothing special. So it's exactly how it should be, right? But you know, I actually think that there is something that we can show them that would be really interesting and unforgettable. Something they most probably haven't seen in any of the other planetary systems they visited before. And the funny thing is, it's rather usual for us humans on Earth, as we see it almost every day. So, I believe that the most exciting tourist attraction of the entire solar system is our moon. You might not agree with me yet, but let me explain myself. The moon always shows us the same face, which is how most big satellites of planets behave due to a feature called tidal locking. It's also rather big compared to our planet, but all that is not what makes it special. The really cool thing is that the moon is about 400 times smaller than the sun, and at the same time, it's about 400 times closer to Earth. That is definitely a coincidence that doesn't come up that often, even in other planetary systems. As a result, when you see the moon from Earth, it's almost exactly the same size on the sky as the sun. So, when their paths cross, we see a thing called total solar eclipse. If you look at it from the right spot, for a brief moment the discs align and match almost perfectly, it gets dark, but at the same time you can see the corona of the sun and it's almost magical. If the moon was smaller, it would look something like an eclipse on Mars. Here's one that was taken by Perseverance earlier this year. As you can see, it's just a transit of Phobos, nothing really exciting. If it was bigger, it would just go dark for a while during the eclipse and it would also be rather boring. So if I had a task to show interstellar tourists something that they most probably haven't seen anywhere else, I would show them the total solar eclipse as it's seen from Earth. I bet there aren't many places in the entire cosmos where the angular size of the satellites on the sky matches the angular size of the star so perfectly, creating this magical view that we are privileged to see every several years. And in addition to that, I would make a fortune selling them old floppy disks as souvenirs so they can remember the experience. Leave a like to this video if you're actually old enough to know what the connection is. Also, if you have other ideas that would make a great tourist attraction for aliens, leave your suggestions in the comment section. But remember the rules. It has to be something unique that they didn't see anywhere else. Something that makes our solar system stand out from the other ones they visit and be remembered by. Maybe I missed something and you can point it out. And of course, give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. We are a small channel, so we really need it. Subscribe for more quick and funny space content like that. Support us on Patreon if you feel like it. But most importantly, stay curious, my friends.